Hello, welcome to RC Video Reviews. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to flash and configure the Matek CRSF to PWM-C converter board. If you start flying Express LRS and need more than 6 channels of output on PWM, you're going to need to look at one of these converter boards by Matek. This supports 10 channels, and it's also got a CLI that allows us to upgrade the firmware and make some minor configuration changes to the board. So I'm going to show you how to do that via Betaflight Passthrough today. You can also do this with an FTDI dongle. I don't have one of those, but I do have a Matek controller. So I'll show you how to do it on Betaflight. Very simple to do. And keep in mind, pretty much the same procedure applies for the FTDI board, except obviously you skip the Betaflight steps. Okay, with that in mind, let's take a quick look at the board because there's a real important thing you need to understand about wiring. This is my Betaflight controller on the left, and you can see that I'm using UART number 5, so TX number 5 and RX number 5. Now that's important later when we get into Betaflight. I need you to remember that number 5. But for wiring, the main thing that I see people get into trouble with when it comes to connecting UART peripherals is they don't cross the wires. This pad on the Betaflight controller is TX number 5. That stands for transmit. So that's the yellow wire. And when I wire that to this board, the Matek board, I'm going to send that TX line to the RX pin on this board. So TX goes to RX, and then you see the white wire is connected to the RX pad, and RX will go to TX. That's the important thing to do on these UART type connections. You got to flip that RX and TX pair. That's how they talk to each other. And then on this particular board, I've got my 5 volt and ground down here on the left, and those will go to ground and 4.5 volt on the Matek board. I've got my Matek board all soldered up and ready to go. One other thing I want to point out, you have to connect your Betaflight controller to the second row of pins. This will be the second UART on this controller board, not the first row. I've never tried it on the first row, but the instructions are pretty clear. You need to do it on the second row. All right, here's my 4-pin header from the Betaflight board. I'm just going to connect that to the Matek board. And then the only other thing to do is take the USB cable for your Betaflight board and plug that in. You do not need to apply power via batteries to the Matek board. The power coming off of the Betaflight controller is sufficient. With our Betaflight controller connected to the computer, we can go ahead and flip over to Betaflight, and Betaflight should auto-detect the COM port for your controller. Once you see that COM port auto-detected, go ahead and hit connect, and then we're gonna go down over here to the CLI, and in the CLI, we have one simple command we have to enter, and that is serial. We're gonna type serial pass through. And if you remember earlier, I asked you to remember a number, and that number was the UART pad on my Betaflight controller, and I'm using UART number 5. In order to do serial pass through, you do UART minus 1. So in my case, it was UART number 5. That means I have to subtract 1, so I'm going to use 4 there, and then I'm going to put in a baud rate of 115200 and hit enter. Now that I've done that, we'll go up to Betaflight and hit disconnect twice. I don't know why I have to hit it twice, but I click it one time. There's a disconnect, it didn't actually disconnect. Now hit it again, and that actually disconnects it. It doesn't matter if you close Betaflight or not, but just disconnect it. And once you have it disconnected, you can go over to the Matek configurator. I will have a link for this in the description, so don't worry, you don't have to type it or anything. I'll put a link in the description so you can download it. There is no install process, it's just a basic executable, so you just run it. So you download it and run it. And then once you run it and you've done your work in Betaflight, you click on this COM port selection. Remember, mine is COM5. And the baud rate, I'm leaving at 115200, and we'll hit connect. And when you see the screen pop up with information on the firmware and your servo timings and your output remaps, then you know you're in. The next thing we'll do is we'll click open file. And again, I'll have links to the firmware in the description, so you don't have to worry about it. And I'm gonna grab the latest available, which is 2.3.0, and I hit open file, and now I'll hit upgrade. And once you start seeing these little characters flashing across the screen, that means you've got a good connection, you've got an upgrade going, and everything is good. Okay, with the flash complete, you'll get this bootloader response showing version 1.2.1. After about 10 seconds, you'll see this prompt that says switch the UART function to CLI, and from there we can get into configuration. Type the command help in the window, and this will give you a list of things that you can do with this command line interface on the Matek board. So the first thing I'll do is just type version, and that'll verify that we've got the correct firmware on the board. In this case, it's 2.3.0, so that's correct. And then you can also type in get failsafe, and that'll show you what's going on with failsafe settings on the board. Now, the failsafe settings aren't configurable. This is something that the board will pick up when you're bound to your receiver. When you first connect, it'll read what your sticks are doing. That's how it sets the failsafe. So those are the failsafe options. And when you type get channel, you see the current PWM value of a channel if you have a receiver connected, otherwise it just shows the failsafe value. The get time command shows the PWM frequency of each channel, and if you want to change that, you simply type the command set TIM and then pick the channel you want. So I'm going to use 2, and that is channels 1, 2, and 4. I don't know why they do it this way, so don't ask. It's just the way they do it. So set time 2 equals 100, and when I do that, it sets channels 1, 2, and 4 to an output frequency of 100. If I want to set it back to 330, simply type set time 2 equals 330, and that sets the PWM frequency back to 330 hertz. The next command is get scale, and I'm going to show you the Matek website to give you an idea of how these VBAT and current scale options work. The main thing is they're intended to let you calibrate the voltage and the current that you're actually seeing on your OSD or via multimeter. You can adjust the scale of your voltage and current by using the command set VBAT scale or set current scale and use some tool to measure what you need. So if your multimeter says you're running some voltage, you need to increase or decrease it, you would set the scale here to make sure that the reading you're getting off the board correlates with what you're seeing on your meter. Same thing goes with current, except there's a little bit of a formula I'll point out. So if your current readout is 10 amps on telemetry and 10.8 on your current meter, you set the scale by using your red value of 10.8, divide that by what your OSD is displaying, and then multiplying that times the current scale, which is 150. And that gives you your new scale value of 162. So you'd simply enter set current scale equals 162 to calibrate your current on this one. And while we're on this page, the last command is set output 5. In Express LRS, they use channel 5 or aux 1 as a 1-bit channel for arming purposes. So if you want to reassign the output on pin 5 to either channel 11 or 12, you can do that. And if you're using Express LRS 3.0 or higher, there is a mode that gives you 16 channels of proportional. If you assign channel 11 or 12, that gives you one more fully proportional output on pin 5. When you're finished with your configuration, you can hit disconnect. After you've disconnected from the Matek configurator, you can go back to your Betaflight board and disconnect the USB cable to your computer, and then you can disconnect the Betaflight board from the Matek board, and you're all done. Okay, that wraps up my video on how to flash and configure the Matek CRSF to PWM-C converter board. I hope you found the information useful, and if you did, please subscribe and hit that notification bell down below so you know new videos hit the channel. That's all I've got for today. Take it easy. Hey, if you like the work I do here on RC Video Reviews, please consider joining me on Patreon. For about the price of a cup of coffee, you can help me keep making videos just like this one. If you'd like to help out, there's a link in the description and on your screen.